the show has come entirely full circle. I started the show talking about how we can't sleep on the old guys. We love the veterans. They don't get enough love. And as we start out our wide receiver busts, I'm going to completely bust an old guy. And that's Demaryius Thomas. No, Demaryius Thomas, the reason I don't like him is, unlike Marshawn Lynch, his numbers have trended downward each of the past few seasons. You can certainly blame the quarterbacks, and that's rightfully so. But is it possible that he's just slowing down? He's not a spring chicken anymore. I know he's not 30 years old, and I'm sorry that I just used the term spring chicken. But Demaryius Thomas is trending in the wrong direction no matter what way you look at it. He's not nearly as strong or as versatile or as consistent as he was in his younger years. Yes, positive touchdown regression could be coming. Yes, he may have more receptions with a better quarterback. Yes, he may have more yards. But I don't think it's a guarantee anymore. Demaryius Thomas was a guy that was a rock-solid wide receiver one for a long time in this league. And I don't think he is anymore. And to be fair, you don't have to draft him as that. But there's just higher upside wide receiver twos that I'm more interested in. Give me a Stephon Diggs over Demaryius Thomas. Give me the upside of Amari Cooper over a Demaryius Thomas. Gets Amari Cooper in a second. But I don't want anything to do with Demaryius Thomas.
Yeah, I think this just goes back to where he's being drafted right now. Consistently going in the fourth round. If you ask me, I'd rather wait a few rounds later and take a wide receiver that plays opposite Demaryius Thomas in Emmanuel Sanders, who really seems to hit his peak. He's at a fine age, too. But Demaryius Thomas, look, he's had so many injuries the past couple of years. The groin, the hip. Last year dealing with hamstring, knee injuries. It's just he's taken a beating over the past couple seasons. The numbers are trending downwards. Like you've mentioned, Gregg, he only has 5 touchdowns in each of the past 2 years. Another thing, he's not playing with Peyton Manning anymore. He's now playing with Case Keenum. And Case Keenum was serviceable last year. And people are going to try to say, well, Case Keenum made 2 Vikings receivers fantasy viable last year in Stephon Diggs and Adam Thielen. Those guys are much younger, much more dynamic talents. And to be fair, we don't know who Case Keenum is going to favor in this offense. Maybe it's going to be Emmanuel Sanders. Maybe he throws the ball to the running backs more. Maybe it's Jake Butt up there in Denver. So I think for all those reasons, just mainly where he's being drafted is the biggest problem I have with Demaryius Thomas. In the fourth round, I just can't pull that trigger, Gregg.
Yeah, I just think Demaryius Thomas in the fourth round, the value, simply put, is not good enough. There's no upside even anymore. I hate picking players at their peak, and I think that's where Demaryius Thomas's peak is, unfortunately, at this point.
Take Jarvis Landry over him in that range right now, who seems to be clicking in the Cleveland offense. Juju Smith-Schuster, the complete antithesis of what Demaryius Thomas is, a young player who is now on the rise, playing in a potent offense there with the Steelers. So both of those guys in the fourth round, give me them over Demaryius Thomas, Gregg.